Yes, this is a... The developers are... First of all... Master volume needs to go very, very down. So, music probably... It's 75, so it's not overpowered by everything else. Put sound effects at 90. We should make this even lower. Alright. So, full disclosure for this game. I requested a key from this developer. So, this is going off... My perception of this game will be going off such a lazy Stacy. That's a... Idle 1 minute. I'm actually going to see how this game plays at very high settings. Yeah, 1920 by 1080. Let me sync off. I think it should play fine at the highest settings, because this game didn't look like it was very demanding. But yeah, full disclosure, Right Nice Games gave me a key for this after I requested it on their website, because this game looked interesting enough. I think I was gonna buy this anyway, because... Alright, that I like. You can switch back and forth between controller and keyboard. But thank you to the developers for agreeing to give me a key for this game. I've been... With some of the platformers that have been coming out lately, I wanted to check out at least one of them. Snake Pass I want to get to eventually. Ukulele might not be for me, because I don't really like... I don't really like platformers that are collectible heavy, like Banjo-Kazooie, because I don't really like it when games have collectibles for the sake of having collectibles. I like it when the collectibles actually matter to gameplay. Like Ratchet & Clank is an example of that. For me, the fun comes from level design. Not how many collectibles you can put in one map.
A relic from the ancient progenitor civilization has surfaced, and I fear what could happen if it fell into the wrong hands. Some say heroes aren't born. Heroes are made. I guess cliches exist for a reason, because our hero is just in the making.
Bob, how is our test subject doing? Oh, well, look who's awake, our little thief. Are you really so stupid as to think you could steal from the great CRT? Heck, I'm not even sure how you're still alive after that gruesome reconstruction. But hey, I'm not complaining. Once your brand new arm's complete, you'll be able to sucker punch people into orbit, baby. Now, if all this sounds a little strange to you, it's probably because I've started removing your memories. I know, a tad extreme, but that's just how I roll. Can't let you keep that pesky free will of yours, can we?
That's not nice.
Okay, bye now.
Installation complete. This was a rather unfortunate turn of events, although you no longer remember said events. Stand by. Initialize kinetic weapon system. It would seem that you have a much greater role to play, Skylar. Let's get you out of here.
Hey, Mala. I may actually have to move the chat so it doesn't cover up the subtitles.
First things first. Are you able to walk?
Oh no, wait, it seems like it's fine. It's just for the cutscenes. Okay. Whoa. Actually, this is... Oh, I'm gonna turn my air on, because my computer's, like, red hot. Looks a little laggy in OBS, which is weird, because it's still 60 for me. But I don't have any dropped frames. How's it look? Is it, like, really... Is it rough? Oh yeah, for some reason, the FPS... The FPS is kind of stuck at 30. Seems pretty smooth? Alright. Yeah, no dropped frames, but for some reason the frame rate's down on the stream. But the game itself seems like it's fine. Okay, actually, give me 1 second, though. I'm gonna turn off the overhead fan. But yeah, I'm gonna stream this for...
You seem to be fit as a fiddle. Now, I am more than a regular arm.
I'm gonna stream this for at least a couple hours if I'm enjoying it, maybe an extra hour, and then I'll switch to Doom.
Use me to punch through those boxes.
Hey, you can double jump right off the bat. That's pretty neat. Graphics actually look pretty neat. I like the aesthetic.
Don't bother jumping those containers, though. It's not like you can jump twice in the air or something.
I already figured that out for myself, buddy. I can't. Nah, I can't. Nice try, though. She moves fast. Can you look around? I saw that someone was complaining that, like, the camera, when it pans down like this, it goes, but it seems like it's fine to me. Like, it gets too close to her and it's hard to really look up. I mean, it is kind of the case, but it's not too bad. It might depend on what aspect or...
Bob? You never told me she was gravity-defying.
It might depend on, what you have your resolution set at. Little Jaggy, that's a little off-putting.
My other function on this swarm lock, the spin attack.
Oh. Took damage right off the bat. Seems like the spin can keep you in the air for longer. Why doesn't do anything yet?
the spin attack also functions as a triple jump while in the air.
If you hold it, nah, if you hold it, it doesn't do anything.
Oh, so you slapped around Dave and Steve. They were useless anyway. Alright, end of the road, you rascal. You can't get through here.
Oh, do these give me more health? Okay, that's what the Y button is. Seems like it does it automatically. Okay, so to bring the camera, like, immediately right behind you, it's left trigger. There's an area to explore down here, though. I think. Okay, so you can't swim. Better that I find that out now. At least you don't die, you just lose a life, lose a heart. Oh shit. I have to say, it's a shame that it's only coming in at like... It's weird that it's coming in at like 30 FPS on stream, because I have the stream set to 60. But it doesn't seem like it's shooting down a lot for my computer, though. On my computer, it's like running a lot better. So I don't really know why that's the case. It's not even CPU intensive, because it's still only using up, like, a normal amount.
See those swing nodes? Use your grappling beam to swing through the air.
Bob? What do those things even do? She's... getting away! You're forcing my hand here, kitten.
Okay, all you have to do is
time
press
to
it.
Wake up our little
ah, kitten.
Friend.
I get it. That's cute. Not really. Oh, is there stuff down here? I don't know if there's... I should probably figure out if there's fall damage. Probably not, but... I don't see anything else. So. Seems like you don't have to worry about swingers. Oh. Let me see. Okay, so you don't have to really worry about centering yourself when you're on a swing like this. It kind of centers it for you. Lame Twitch, they don't want you to have the best streaming experience.
End of the line, kitty cat. Get her! Ah, dang it, you imbecile. You complete...
Now's your chance, Skylar. Escape.
Kinda looks like Skylar is a silent protagonist.
Brace for impact.
least for now.
No way! Today's Ugh. Finally the day! Woo! This is it! I'm outie! Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
Feathery friend.
Greetings, you guys. I'm Plux, and these islands are my home.
I'll be honest, the acting's not so great.
Delighted to make your acquaintance, Plux, but we have urgent matters to attend to. Skylar, if you wish to regain the memory CRT erased, you must find the progenitor structure called the siphon.
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about. The Islanders always jam about that thing. It's some huge, ancient-looking thingamajig, right?
That, sounds just like it, I guess. Can you take us there?
I know these islands like the back of my wing. Let me show you the way.
I mean, yeah, the art is still really good, though. I do like the art team on this. Animations on all the characters seem pretty solid, too. Controls are actually very nice and loose. Yeah, I know, I like them. A lot. It's just, like, look at this, for instance. Like, that definitely shouldn't be. That edge is, like, way too rough. That's, like, the second thing I saw. Music works really well for this game, though. So, let's see. I could just keep going down this way, but I'm gonna get all that stuff. I'm not gonna judge it too harshly. But this is technically a final release. This is not an early access. This game is only $15 on Steam, though. And it is as far as I know, the dev team is very small. So, some of this stuff is so far forgivable. Most of it, actually. This is an independently developed team. It was an indie studio, but it seems like they have a publisher. Maybe it's an indie publisher, I don't know. But it's a publisher I never heard of, if it is. Like, I don't know. Like, Right Nice is the dev studio credited for it, but I don't know exactly. Maybe they're the production studio, Grip Digital. Maybe they're not a publisher. But it's $15 on Steam right now. And this is a final release. So, I'm not gonna judge it too harshly. Unless it takes, like, a really bad turn. I don't get that feeling about this game, though. Because the controls play nice. You, like, stop on a dime, so that's actually good. It's not like... I thought it would be slippery because of how you turn like this, but it actually isn't. It's pretty solid, actually. I mean, tested out the mouse and keyboard controls, but you can move in between all of them. It's WSAD to move, like I'm using it right now. Friend of the dev team here. Oh, hello! Alva Toby, welcome. Here, I'll read this real quick. Right Nice is the dev team, started out as a 4-week school project when they just started the game dev school. Alright. In Stockholm, Sweden. Alright. Yeah, thank you for that description. It puts a lot, it actually does put it into perspective. This was a school project? That just clicked. Or it started out as a 4-week school project, I'm assuming, right? Is what it seems like you're getting at. Yeah, started out, alright. I didn't read it right at first. But, yeah, pretty impressive when it, considering the origin. So far, anyway. I'm still, like, right at the beginning. Alright, I think I missed too much. I gotta go back. But, yeah, thank you for putting that into perspective. Yeah, sorry if it looks choppy. So far someone said it looks fine on their end, but for like some reason the frame rate keeps dipping. It's not dipping on my end though, it's just on the stream's end. Started out. Then I got a bit of attention on Reddit, and they went on to win some awards. Guess we have to finish it now. Well, so far I'm kinda glad for that. Because like I said, it's only been... Oh. Because, as I was saying, okay. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe OBS is lying to me, I don't know. Yeah. There has been, like, a very recent influx of platformers made by smaller studios. Like, Snake Pass is one that I haven't tried yet. Then there was that crowdfunded one called Ukulele that's reminiscent of Banjo-Kazooie. And although I don't like the collectible-heavy ones like that, I like that they're coming back because I used to have a lot of fun with those when I was younger. Like Ratchet & Clank, Jak & Daxter, and things like that. So, I welcome games that are like this. I want to see them return, outside of Nintendo. Because they've been doing it for years, of course. And as much as I do like Nintendo, I want to see more original projects like this. So I was actually quite intrigued when I first saw this on the Keymailer website. She does look really pretty.
Wait, is that the Elder? What is she doing in a cage?
Plux, is that you? Could you ask your feline friend to please get rid of these monsters?
Don't you worry your blobby little head.
I do like that there's not really a map, but I don't think that'll be a problem. Open world areas, another plus. Or open world like. What's the phrase I'm looking for? I'm sorry. Oh, the music changed. I'm curious. I am a cat after all. Oh god! Oh god! you didn't see that. It doesn't really look like there's anything this way. Oh, something is on fire up there. That's not anything, it looks like. Oh wait, that's a platform right there. Oh, can't go in there. I could go down there if I wanted to. So I can go over here, but it doesn't really look like there's anything needed. Uh-oh. How do I get back? Maybe this way. Uh-oh. Oh, here we are. I'm not sure if that was intended or not. But I didn't get stuck over there, at least. It doesn't... looks like that's certain death. So, I probably can't get there right now. I did like, I really like that, that music change, though. That was really neat. Oh, hi.
Well done, young one. Now, would you kindly release me from this cage? If you don't have enough gems, there should be a few boxes nearby that are full of them.
Oh, it's that thing up there. It's just a cost. 300.
Oh, thank you, young one. And thank you, too.
Hey, don't sweat it. But what in the name of funk is going on?
A terrible calamity has struck our island. And he calls himself the CRT. His greedy attempt to deconstruct the siphon broke it apart, and I can feel the life force of this moon seeping away. It's an ancient progenitor mechanism powered by three fuses. As the CRT stole one of them, the other two returned to their original places of creation. On the highest point of the island. In the seed lost in time. And the stolen one is kept in a fortress of steel. He has imprisoned my people, the Loar, trying to extort us into revealing the fuse's locations. Oh, please, if you find any of my children, break open their cages just like mine. And for the trouble, I will increase your health. So if you ever feel
sweet.
Weak, and beat down, remember to come and talk to me.
That sure seems like a tall order. I'm sure you'll do fine, Skylar. Pleasure meeting you.
Plux, I know you haven't embraced Clover Island as your home, and I understand that. But it needs you now more than ever.
What? Me?
You know this island, so you must guide Skylar on her journey.
I guess I know my way around.
Sure, if you say so, Jelly Beans.
Very good, my friends. And Skylar, let Clover Mountain be a trial of your courage. Best of luck to you both.
All right, let's go on an adventure.
Open 5 for, all right, the next one.
You seek to reconquer what CRT stole from you, yes? Only the siphon will allow that. But without the fuses, it remains broken. Your journey begins at the foot of Clover Mountain.
Okay, so there's like several doors I can go through. She has like 3 animations for that. This is definitely a unique looking game. That's a good thing, though. I've never seen character designs like this before. Oh, she does point. I see, so it looks like there's about 5 areas, and then... that space station up top. I do like the music change when you go to new areas. That's neat. It reminds me of Jak and Daxter a lot. I should really go back and play that game. I'd like to... I haven't played it in probably over a decade.
Alrighty then. I've been soaring around this place for years. Finding that fuse should be a piece of cake.
Ooh. Nice, it's snow level. Or at least eventually it will be.
Let's not be away for too long. I'm waiting for my papa to come and get me. He'll be back any day now.
Oh, Jesus.
Going up?
Not yet. You're getting ahead of yourself there, Plux. Alright, later, Alpha. Thanks for coming in and giving
your
me
will is no longer your own.
And thank you for the follow. Sorry that I made you insane. But that's how we roll here. Oh god. How much is it for the... oh, that's only 100. But I did so- alright. How rude, they push you back. there anywhere I can go up here? It doesn't look like it. That's too high to actually jump to. Definitely have to say, the level design's very straightforward. Oh, what's over here, though? Hello, you are partially hidden. Okay, so they do have little, like, hidden, semi-hidden caged birds. That's neat. Gonna look out for those. Ouch. Also, I'm very impressed with the choice of graphical options. Surprisingly enough, AAA studios don't get that right sometimes. I didn't notice. When you pick those up, they have their own different tones to them. Can I get up there? Nah, it looks like I'm gonna be led up there that way.
This grungy metal stuff wasn't here before. We'll have to get around it somehow.
Excuse me.
Hey, look! There's a thingamajig straight ahead. Let's see what it is.
In a second. I kinda just have to collect everything else first. There is a ground pound. I probably found that out earlier and I just didn't realize. Alright, unless I can get in there eventually, but not right now. Ching. Getting these achievements left and right. Is there? Nah. Wait, is this like a pad or something? Nah, maybe that'll work later. Or maybe... Nope. Maybe that's what this power-up's for. There is like a yellow thing over there.
You to hover through the air, rocket jump to high places, and rocket roll over your enemies. Remember, keep an eye on your energy meter.
Once a thief,
looks like there's gonna be more of them, so.
Ain't that the truth, huh, pussycat? Well, fine. It's just a prototype anyway. Probably just gonna break it like you do everything else. And who's that talking through your arm anyway? Bob? Is it supposed to do that?
Entirely sure, sir.
Then what am I even paying you for?
Alright, so it's
Rachel. Actually paying me, sir.
Oh, right. Silly me.
So it's a high jump. Oh, it's a high jump, and you can also glide with it. That's I like that. Okay, it looks like we'll be able to make that come down at some point. Here's this owl thing that we're supposed to free. Oh, Jesus, you almost knocked me off. Okay, I can see a little bit why people were complaining a little about the camera, but that's more so the foliage, not the, like, maybe a first-person button or something like that? Like, you can press in on one of the analog buttons on the controller, and it'll go into first-person, so you can look around a little bit better. This is a new area I can explore. Or did I just go backwards? Yeah, I just went backwards. Eh. Can I go back up, though? Or can I go up to a new place? Doesn't look like it. Oh, wait. Did I really not get those? That was interesting. I guess it was just a way that I didn't go yet. I actually kind of forget where I need to go. So I don't know if this is backwards or... I have no idea how I managed to somehow get myself lost. I'm right at the beginning. Maybe this isn't the beginning. I know, here we are. I feel like an idiot. Can't go up that way. Okay. Can't crouch, so you can't go under that. Oh god. Alright. Nothing left, nothing right. Oh, can you still jump when you're up high like that? Nah. I almost thought you could. You can do the spin, though. Is there? Oh! That's another one. Some of these birds that you have to free are semi-hidden. Okay. Oh, oh! I thought I had to press the button first. Okay, so that disables that.
Cool. The passage is open.
Is that everything up here? I think it is. Yes. rocket roll. Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, it reminds me of the roll launch from Jack and Daxter. Hey, Beta. Yeah, pretty much. This is a cute game so far. Oh god! I just wanted to practice that again. Oh wait. Oh wait, that's where I came from, alright? I thought it was... there's no lower path. Clover Mountain, bouncy bed.
I love this place. Soothing and easy on the eyes.
I think the words you're looking for are chaotic and, hideous.
No! What's your deal, man?
My deal? This pathetic island is my deal, Pigeon. As in, I own it. I'll turn this wilderness into something more productive.
You can't.
No? That's exactly what those pesky natives said. And look where they are now. anyway, tell me when you and Kitty Cat are done sulking and ready to get to work.
Whatever he's got planned, it can't be good. We really do have to do something, don't we?
Oh, I can go back up this way. Oh! Is there something in here? Nah.
So we gotta find two more of these.
Nothing else. So I'm assuming that you can go backwards from some of these areas. I almost thought he'd hit me in midair. I'm seeking a... oh. I guess it's just sand. Of course, I'd sink into the ground. Oh. Oh! There we are. How you doing, Lily Beta? I don't know if you're still there. If there's any fall damage, I don't think there is. Alright. I was jumping too high. That's what got me hit last time. It's also weird, I've noticed that now my frame rate's, or at least OBS is saying that my frame rate is now solid 60. I have no idea why it was telling me that it was dropping earlier. I wasn't actually dropping any frames, I was just saying that the frame rate was getting... was shooting like 30 and 20, but it really wasn't. Oh well. It just had an update, so maybe it's just like acting a little weird. I almost feel like I wouldn't be able to make that. Oh, here we got another hidden one here. Okay, so that's seven. Oh! Did he actually kill that other one? Ow. There. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything up on that. Hold on. Maybe there is. Now, you know what? Now I'm thinking about it. You know why I think this game is running so well? I read. They used the Unreal Engine. They could have easily used Unity if they wanted to. I'm kind of glad that they didn't. Not that Unity is necessarily a bad engine, it's just that... most of the time, it's not really used very well. With a lot of the different games that I've witnessed. Unreal has a very good history of making most games run very smooth, so... it's probably a good idea on their part. Oh, can I go up here? Now, it's kind of neat that you can go up to places like this. Like, they don't have invisible walls everywhere, but... again, I won't fault them too much, because it's a small group of people who had developed this game, and it's... the price on Steam is cheap. In fact, I think it's on sale right now. But it would be kind of nice if they were to ever do more with this game, or like, say, a sequel or something like that. When you explore areas like this, that you get rewarded like with a power-up or something like that. Because it was neat that I could climb up there like that, and it almost seemed like they were going to put something there. Thank you. don't think I missed anything. Okay, I went that way. Oh, there's a few things I can get over there. Oh wait, there it goes. Oh god, I almost screwed myself over. They have some of those crystals, too. There's a second one. Be patient, Plux, be patient. I really like this music. I don't know, I really like the piano. It stands out surprisingly. In a good way. I don't know, it's very pleasant fitting. I actually missed this button. Follow the cord. Okay, so maybe I didn't. Just keep going this way. Did I actually... I think I actually had to go up there. I wasn't observant enough. So there was a point going up there. I don't wait. I mean, you could still go up there if you wanted to, but... You jump off from there. You're crying. It's probably behind this. Yeah, there it is. Also, more points to them, they didn't use a bunch of stock sound effects that I recognize. I don't know if they recorded it themselves, or I don't know, maybe they... I don't know how it works as far as... making sound effects, buying sound effects. I know you can probably... There's probably something that you can do, but I don't work in games, so I'm not sure how everything works. But I do know that there's... sound effects that are open resource, sometimes you use them in, like, or public domain, and then sometimes I think the engine might come with it. I know with Unity it comes with a bunch of resources you can use. But I'm not sure if that's also true for Unreal. But all of the sound effects, like, nothing stands out as something that I've actually heard before. And I have somewhat of an ear for that.
Uh-oh, I see fire!
But considering how good the music is, the sound department did a pretty damn good job. I could save myself there. That was a little, that was a tad scary.
Oh no! How could he do this?
Oh, that was easy peasy lemon squeezy. The natives just couldn't dig the vision I had for this place, so burn, baby, burn.
You won't get away with this!
Watch me.
Oh, you can actually hit those things out of the air. Oh. Can I get over there? Hello, this is actually kind of cool. Maybe I should go up this way. Doesn't look like there's anything. Or did I get everything over here already? Maybe some of the enemies were over here. You can definitely tell the developers of this game have played both Jak and Daxter and Ratchet and Clank, because I'm definitely noticing elements from both. Not quite, but I am having a lot of fun with it right now, out of nowhere.
This is a teleportation station. Activating them will let you teleport between other activated terminals.
Okay, so I can use this to go back to the main island, I guess, if I wanted to. And these are all the areas I explored. Hey, what about... Can I get more life from this lady?
You seek to reconquer what CRT stole from you, yes? Only the siphon will allow that. But without the fuses, it remains broken. You have shown great kindness, Skylar. To reward you for your hard work, I have increased your health.
Oh yeah, I actually haven't, I haven't finished this area yet, either. Were these all the things that I freed? I get these? I guess I do. This seems more like it's a hub world. But there's still... there's 8 of those owl things that I still haven't saved yet. I don't know if these things are respawning or what. I think they are, actually. Is there anything that I missed back here? Yeah, I'm certain that all those boxes are respawning. Oh wow, she actually gave me 2 hearts. Alright, go back here. Miss those.
I should have brought my winter plunge.
Oh, that's flying in midair. I'm under. There we go. I don't know if that was intended. Another one. Oh shit. Doesn't look like... nah, never mind. I'm thinking a little too complicated. This game is not complicated. Intercepted. Oh, another one. Oh god! Okay, I think I can actually do it that way. I just think I just did it too soon. Oh wait, I don't think I can do it that way. I'm just too short. So, I just gotta steer clear of it. I probably should have spun, but at least I didn't get hit. Let's see, nothing else. Critical thinking need not apply. Yeah, pretty much. Die! Jumping beam. I mean, I almost feel like I should take the mature content filter off, because this doesn't really seem like it's geared toward kids. At the same time, though, I wouldn't be able to control my swearing. So, it stays on.
I'd come up here when I was little. Well, littler. I'd look up at the sky, wondering if Papa was out there somewhere. On his way back.
I almost completely missed what Plux said. I'm a terrible Christian. You discovered my dirty secret. You gotta go first. Ow. I'm gonna take out these other little jumping TVs. Ended up killing itself. Can't touch this. 10 enemies without losing health. Starting to think your username is a hazard to the whole stream philosophy. Wholesome? What? To the whole wholesome philosophy, I guess is.
Your butts, that is. See ya.
Wouldn't want to be ya.
Charlatan. Oh, I can't knock that down. I'm gonna like a tree.
This high up?
Probably right above me. Oh.
Ruins? This high up? Hey, look! That must be the fuse!
There you are. It's another warp. Alright. Is this leading me somewhere? I feel like it is. Oh god. There. That was a bit of a risk. Okay. Oh, there's a planet up there. Okay, so it didn't really seem like that led anywhere. It just kind of... It just got me more crystals. I can see my house from here. I just get to the top. No! Ah! I pressed down by mistake. Oh well, I'm not going back around that way just to collect more of them. Missing two birds, though.
Yeah.
Bob, what happened to the thief?
I'm not quite sure, sir. When she grabbed the fuse, it triggered something. It imprinted some of its power in her arm.
Well, ain't that cute. Flush her out into space and be done with it.
With all due respect, sir, I think she's worth more to you alive. We can see her power in some kind of glove and...
Shut up, Bob! I've got it!
These are some of... We're remembering a little bit more.
Kind of glove, she could become some kind of super weapon!
Very good, sir. Quite genius, indeed.
I know, Bob. Make the preparation. This kitty cat is getting a new paw.
Thank you.
Phew, that was pretty impressive, buddy. Let's go talk to the Elder.
I mean, we could, but I was missing two. I want to go back here. I'm missing two birds. Actually, maybe I should go back and use that, like, teleporter. Because I probably missed them near the end. I don't think I missed them in the beginning. Yeah, they just respawn. So if you don't have enough to free more birds, you can always just come back here and farm them a bit. And keep resetting. There's a fun amount, though. They give you plenty as it is, so I don't think you'd ever run into that issue. It seems like they all appear here eventually as well. Let's go here. It's interesting, because I didn't hear any more of them, so I wonder what two am I missing? Plus, I like this music. Again, much love to the sound department. Because they have like a winning soundtrack, and the sound effects are really good too. Oops. Doesn't look like there's any around here. Is there? Nah, it's just death. Alright. That's probably why they respawn. So you can get more health. Oops. I didn't press it in time. Alright, this goes back up near the... She's a maniac and puppy love. Spin attack 50 enemies. Alright, it's one of those. I went down here because you can't go down there. There's no birds up there. doesn't look like I can go over there either. Well, worst comes to worst, I'll just maybe go back and 100% this on my own. Let's say I have, like, something later on that lets you actually see where they are. Yeah, that just goes back to lowering the level, I think. Or not. Unless that is literally... That does kind of look like that's just part of a level that I came from. Yeah, it is. Let's see, so... What else is around here? I mean, it doesn't look like there's much else. No bird up there. Wait, am I? Wow. I actually didn't realize I could go back to the... This is actually kind of neat. I don't know how intended this was, though. Let's see what happens. You could go back to really early in the level if you wanted. Oh, here we go. Here's one I missed. You all didn't respond, did they? I'm wondering if I missed both of them in this section. I don't see the other one from here, though. Maybe, is that it? Oops. I wonder if that's it. That must be the... because I'd never been there before. Yeah, there it is. How do I... I don't even think I can get over there right now. Might need another power up for that. Because that seems like it's really far away. Yeah. There is no way I can get to that. The only way I think maybe is if I go from up there, but that's taking a huge risk. Might need another power up for that. where's that thing at? I thought it was over here. Maybe not. I think I can get back this way, though. There it is. Alright. I have to remember this place. Okay, talk to the owl lady. Oh, there's one over here. Why is that so far up in the sky? I think there might be another one over here. Or not. Plenty of these, though. Can I hurt myself on this? I can. Oops. My exploration got the better of me. At least the loading times are fast. Let's look down here first. Oh, they do fly back up. But I'd have to step on them again. Nah, it doesn't look like there's anything down there.
Prove him.
do anything with that. So, is there anything over here? Is there? There's nothing over here. And there's a plant flying in the air. Or maybe I have to climb up here. Yeah, that's weird. There's nothing over there. Maybe I have to do something to affect that later. There's another bird that needs freeing. Oh, Jesus. There we go.
They're all attacking us, you bucket of bolts.
They're attacking you in self-defense. Right, Bob?
Actually, sir, they're correct.
I wonder if I missed something back here. I don't think I did. Wait, did I go up here yet? Oh yeah, I think I already went up here. Yeah, I freed a bird up there. I feel like an idiot, but I have to check again. Yeah, I was already up here. Thank you.
mother said this place was cursed. Or was it sacred? I wasn't really paying attention.
Typically, if it's sacred, it's also cursed. Actually think, I think I'm gonna switch to Doom. I actually could give this, like, at least another hour, but I don't know how long I actually want to stream, and I actually really do want to put in at least 3 hours of Doom. but I will definitely... I'm wondering. Because I don't want to, like, put this off and... Because I don't know how much of Doom I have left. I wanted to do both tonight, and I wanted to check this one out. I think maybe what I might do is... Tomorrow, I'll stream Doom. And then on Monday, I'll stream this. And I'll put in, like, a good 3 hours of this. But... I just really want to play it tonight. I'm not sure if I can push 6 hours of streaming. So... I'm gonna switch games. First impressions of this game so far. Considering the price tag, it's very much worth it so far. It's a neat little simplistic platformer. If you've played games like Ratchet & Clank or Jak and Daxter in the past, there's a lot of elements that are shared here. It encourages some exploration, which is neat. The collectibles in the game seem to just be the crystals, which open up the cages for the birds. So, there's not an emphasis on collectibles, which I like, and the collectibles that are in the game matter. I don't know what actually happens when you get all the birds. I don't know if it'll affect, like, maybe the ending, or if you get something special or what. Movement's very good. The camera I actually had no problems with. The only thing is the, is when you're trying to look up, sometimes the grass can get in the way. There's some graphical errors, but those are really the only complaints that I have. Everything else about it, I really like. And I'm glad that we're seeing more games like this. I hope that continues. I do hope that the developers of this look at this... Know what I likes, or hear up, see how I'm playing the game. I hope this is helpful to them. And like I said, it's